First of all, thanks Marcelinho for the presentation, and thanks for the organizers of Future Cities. I'm really glad to be by the first time in this conference. So my name is Luis Brás. I'm a researcher in the Institute of Telecommunications of Aveiro, and my last research area is being antennas for cars, mainly transparent antennas. And just for you to have a small context of why I'm researching in this area, is like to try to improve the system that Susanna had the pleasure to present before. Susanna already presented a big part of the introduction of this presentation, so I will put this presentation slightly technical, but I promise I will try not to bore all of you. Okay, so for this presentation, I will make a small introduction about the antennas that we are being using for cars that all of you probably already saw, but maybe are not aware about the existence of them, why they are important. After, I will speak about the antennas that we have been implemented in the test bed, mainly for the communication between cars, vehicular communications. After, I will speak about transparent conductors that can be really, let's say, in my point of view, can be really important, like for the future generations of future cities, where we can imagine, like for example, nowadays, imagine the quantity of antennas that we are using, the quantity of antennas that all of you here are using. And okay, if you are here, if you are hiding it in the pocket, maybe it's not a problem, but if you are, for example, in a, I don't know, bus stop, I think you would prefer to have maybe an antenna in the glass, or better, not to see the antenna, than to see one antenna or several antennas. Okay, so first of all, the services and the technologies, some of them that we are using nowadays in the cars. For example, we have a lot of services based in GSM, UMTS. We have the e-tools that all of us use. We have already, okay, it's already available a satellite radio and, for example, even tire pressuring monitoring systems to know, for example, how is the pressure of your tires. That can be really important in safety questions. For example, the remote key entries, for example, you are getting near your car and you don't need the key, for example, to open the car. Okay, all of these, what you have in common? All of them are wireless technologies. So if they are wireless technologies, they imply the use of antennas. Okay, and for this, just for you to have an idea about the spectrum that you are using of diverse technologies in the cars, that can go from the order of megahertz, where you have AM, FM, you have GSM, you have the GPS, okay, you have so many that you can go until the giga order. So, and for example, normally the frequency that you, the higher frequency that you are using, normally is like for radar collision detections. Okay, so when we speak about car antennas or vehicular antennas, first of all, we need to think about the technology and the requirements of the technology. So we need to be aware about the radiation pattern that we need or we want in the antennas, the bandwidth and polarization. Because according with the technologies that you are using, the infrastructure, if it's cellular, if it's based in satellites, we should point our radiation to different points. So of course, you need to be careful in the design of the antennas. But more difficult than designing the antennas is designing antennas for vehicular, because normally you need to be aware about statics, manufacturability, the weather resistance, of course the cost and weight, question of vandalism, for example, how many of you already suffer for somebody stole your antenna of the car, at least I was, and for example, if they are or not reasons to damage, for example, when you are washing the car, tree branches, all these cases. So it is, if you consider everything like this, it starts to become like quite difficult to design them. Okay, so common antennas that you are using in the cars. I will just present some pictures, like just to, for all of you to have an idea, just an integration of this. For example, in the top of the car, in the back side, for example, what I present here as one, normally we have this kind of antennas that I present below, some of them just. Normally it's like for AM and FM, so you have helical antennas, for example. After you have like other antennas normally like made for GPS and for cellular communications. So, for some, not, these are not so common, but normally these are for TV antennas. So if they are based in satellite communication where they use phased arrays. In this position, normally in the upper part of the trunk, they start to use like to integrate a lot of antennas to be able to receive the signal of a lot of technologies. So you are able to receive, for example, AM, FM, digital audio broadcasting, traffic message control, among others. Okay, so after these are maybe more normal, we never saw it inside, but for example, these antennas that normally are used in e-tools that you are passing in iRoads when you're passing by the tools, GPS and some of them for cellular. Okay, some of them are already implemented in the glass, in the rear glass. There's like for all these technologies that I'm here presented. But normally if you look at them, like no, they always try to place them in some place that they do not affect your view, your way, like your sight when you are looking in the mirror. Okay, some of them, these for radar collision avoidance, where they use micro arrays in the front of the car. And these are some examples for tire pressure monitoring systems. Okay. This is just another case, and the last one, that is normally what you have in the car and in your pocket when you have, like, let's say, the key of your car, when you have the remote start engine and the remote key entries. Okay, so this was the antenna that we have the pleasure to implement for the project of the group of Susanna for dedicated short-range communications, where we tried to design a high-efficient microchip antenna array, and we were able to design it and with realistic story results. Okay, but now we start to move to the next step. And we wanted higher gain, we wanted to have the chance to have beam control, but also we wanted like some kind of antenna that had a reduced impact in the driver view. So let's say the driver don't want to see the antenna. Okay, so we start to join, let's say, three things, okay, to increase the gain. Okay, so we start to use, let's say, we are going to use arrays, okay? We want to have beam control, so we are going to work in beamforming networks, okay, and we want to reduce the impact to driver's view. So we start to think, okay, what there is in question of transparent antennas, or I say, moreover, in transparent conductors. Okay, and in this issue, what we saw, it's like there is this material that normally is a film that you place above the glass, that is, I just will speak about this one, that is ITO, indium tin oxide, that maybe for all of you this means nothing. Okay, but just for you to have an idea, like here, it's like some examples. I personally have here some examples, but you cannot see it from there, so I didn't bring them. But it's like you can almost think about them like when you speak about the microscope glasses, like the, I don't know the name in English, that you push to compress the liquids when you are looking through the microscope. But it's really, really hard. It's like for me, I needed to ask help to the manufacturer to teach me how I could distinguish one side that is conductive and the other side that is not conductive. I was not able to see it by myself. So, but okay, this name means nothing, but I could bet that, let's say, 95% of you or even more are having transparent conductors, ITO, in your hands, in your pockets, or in your jackets. Because like this is used in touch screens. So okay, I can bet that almost all of you have smartphones or some iPads that you can can have like touch screen. So here are the two cases that normally you have. You have resistive touch screens that were the previous version, let's say, and now normally they merge to capacitive touch screens. Okay, okay, we need to explain this, but I think this is a little bit interesting. You have here, for example, in the upper part, you have or the plastic or glass. After, you have a thin layer of ITO that I have that small thing here. After, you have spacers, and below you have again a little bit of ITO. So for example, when you have resistive touch screens, what happens is like you are doing strength in plastic, you are getting near the ITO from the other ITO, so you are changing the resistance. So they can detect like you are touching there. And this was made of plastic, so you can see the, in the first version that you can make pressure. And in the others that almost all of you should have, or I think they have, is like it's based in capacitive changes. So it's made in glass, so you have better quality when you are looking. But it detects the changes or electrostatic field. So when you are putting your finger in one place, they can it will change the capacity, so you can detect that you are touching there. And a big advantage of this is like you can use multi-touch, and in the first you cannot. And okay, the only problem is like it's made of glass, so it can break easier. Okay, and so after we start to think about, okay, if can we use these conductive materials in the antennas? Okay, we can, but it has a problem. It has really low efficiency. Okay, so can we still keep the transparency of antennas, but not having so low efficiency? Okay, and we can. Like we can use, for example, grid antennas. And for example, here you have here an example. Okay, the big image of the antenna, and like the upper antenna is the reference antenna that is just made of the metallic sheet. But for example, below you have like the three cases where you have the antenna starting to become more transparent. And what we do is just a question of becoming a grid. If you look to that image, you have that lines that are white, where you can see that these lines are the conductor. And for example, the others is nothing. So the question is, for example, if you start to have bigger space between these conductive lines, you can have like transparent or more transparent antennas, and the efficiency of the antenna is not so different according related to the reference antenna. Okay, this is another case that you can see the approach. So okay, the idea is like, for example, if we can implement this kind of antennas, for example, in the cars. And for when I see in the cars, I repeat again, you can use it in the context of future cities almost everywhere. Okay, and for example, the only thing that I see here, and if you consider about the garbage that we can put here, this is inorganic material. But maybe later, and for sure later, there is already some research, we can move to organic materials to try to decrease the dust that we have in electronics. So as the conclusion and to finish the presentation, I show here the possibility of using transparent antennas for vehicle communications. The ITO-based antennas can be a solution, but they have a quite low efficiency. So how we can improve it, you can use, for example, green antennas. They are a valid solution. And okay, just for you, but I think this is quite logical, is the transparency of the antennas inversely proportional to the antenna efficiency. And like this, I finish my presentation. Thank you all.